the best treatment for the deadliest malaria parasite species. The drugs recommended in this video is a result of data from hundreds of million cases of malaria treatment analyzed by the World Health Organization. In the history of global health, few battles have been as persistent and formidable as the fight against malaria. This ancient disease, transmitted through the bite of infected mosquitoes, continues to haunt regions across the world, especially in tropical and subtropical climates. Malaria is usually a serious and sometimes fatal disease caused by a parasite that commonly infects a certain type of mosquito which feeds on humans. People who get malaria are typically very sick with high fevers, shaking chills, and flu-like illness. The World Health Organization from time to time comes up with update and recommendation for the treatment of malaria, and that is what this video is meant to summarize. The current world standard of treatment of malaria is artemisinin-based combination therapies, which are now the frontline treatment against malaria. These therapies act swiftly, targeting the malaria parasite at different stages of its life cycle and preventing the development of drug resistance. To combat the growing problem of drug-resistant malaria, researchers combined artemisinin with other antimalarial drugs, giving birth to artemisinin-based combination therapies. All episodes of malaria should be treated with at least two effective antimalarial medicines with different mechanisms of action. We call this combination therapy. In simple terms, when we say artemisinin-based combination therapies, ACTs, we mean the patient should use a drug that contains artemisinin together with another antimalarial simultaneously. Children and adults with uncomplicated Plasmodium falciparum malaria should be treated with one of the following ACTs tablets as recommended by World Health Organization. Artemether plus lumefantrine, combined into a tablet as the preferred first line. Artisunate plus amodiaquine, combined into a tablet. Artisunate plus mefloquine, also available as a tablet. Dihydroartemisinin plus piperquine, tablet. Artisunate plus sulfadoxine pyrimethamine, tablet. And artisunate plus pyronaridine. The ACTs are generally highly effective and well-tolerated and should be given for at least 3 days. One of the most incredible things about antimalaria drugs is their potential to not only treat but also prevent malaria. To achieve the best outcome of treatment, dosage regimen should be based on the patient's weight and should provide effective concentrations of antimalarial drugs for a sufficient time to eliminate the infection in all target populations. Since all the drugs mentioned so far are tablets, you might be wondering what happened to those who are so sick that they cannot take tablets. Some patients cannot tolerate oral treatment, hence they should be given injection or rectal administration medications for 1 to 2 days, until they can swallow and retain oral medication reliably. Then, they should also use a full course of ACTs. For severe malaria, initial rectal or injection treatment must always be followed by a full 3-day course of ACTs. Note that, treatment should be initiated as soon as possible, and which drug regimen to treat a patient with malaria depends on the clinical status of the patient, the type of species of the malaria parasite, the area where the infection was acquired and its drug-resistant status, pregnancy status, and finally history of drug allergies or other medications taken by the patient. This will need to be decided by the doctor evaluating the patient. While antimalarial medicines have undoubtedly saved lives, the battle is far from over. Malaria parasites possess a remarkable ability to adapt, leading to the emergence of drug-resistant strains. This challenge underscores the importance of our next video on drug-resistant malaria. So if you have been treating malaria and is not resolving, kindly subscribe to our channel so that you will be notified when the video is out. In recent years, the development of malaria vaccines has marked a paradigm shift in malaria control strategies. The most promising of these is the RTS/S1 vaccine, which has shown significant efficacy, especially in young children. While vaccines do not replace the need for antimalarial medicines, they provide an additional layer of defense, especially in vulnerable populations. We will be making a video on malaria vaccine and you will be notified if you subscribe. The introduction and widespread use of ACTs have significantly contributed to the reduction in malaria-related morbidity and mortality worldwide. And that is why World Health Organization, who recommends ACTs as the first-line treatment for uncomplicated Plasmodium falciparum malaria, the deadliest malaria parasite species, which ensures a higher cure rate and reducing the transmission of the disease. Note that, knowledge is advancing by the day and we will like to always post an update on new advances on how to stay healthy. You can contact us via the link in the description below for any medical inquiry. You are watching Zoom Hospital Channel and listening to work of Dr. Kayode.